So we're starting with a standard face mask. You can get them in bulk on Amazon. So the first step would be to measure the ideal hole location in your mask. For most people, that's on these masks, you want an inch and a half down, or 2 inches, depending on your face size. And then from this arc, you'd want, depending on what side of the hole, you can either have it straight down the middle, which is 3.5 inches, or you could either choose 3 inches from the left or from the right. So I'm gonna do it coming from the left or right if you're facing me of the mask, and then 1.5 to 2 inches down. So once you've marked your standard hole location, you could also put this on your face and just poke where you want to punch the hole. So now that I have that, I'm going to expand if there's any creases where I've marked the hole. You want a firm, durable surface on one side to hold down when you're using this hole punch tool that comes with the grommet kit. You're putting the sharp edge and twisting it to poke the, or to punch the hole. So on the inside of the mask, hold your firm, durable surface. It could either be cardboard, one of these durable heating masks, mats, or an eraser, which is what I'm using. So find your hole, press down on the eraser, and then twist. Your hole. Okay. Set your tools aside. So then the other components, you have the top half of your grommet. It's got a rounded front edge and a small cylindrical embossment on this side. So you'll face that with the rounded side down onto, this is your mandrel or your, no, this is your setting die. I apologize. And then the other half of your grommet tool is a long metal cylinder. It comes with the kit. And you'll take your bottom half, which is a really small disc-shaped cylinder. You'll face that down with the rounded side. There's a flat side and a rounded side. You face the rounded side down on this tool. Okay. And so the front side of your mask is where you want the top half of the grommet. So you'll face that hole on the front side, down onto your setting die with the top half of the grommet on it already. And then the grommet setting tool and the bottom half of the grommet on top. And then you'll hammer that entire assembly down. So with these masks, because they're thinner, sometimes you have to have a little more to like insert your nail in to pull it out. But this is what the hole will look like with the grommet set into it. This is the front of the mask, or back of the mask. The last step is to insert your silicone grommet with the attachable plug. or the attached plug. So to do that, you have the plug. You want that to be aligned so that from the front side, the plug sticking out is parallel to the top and bottom of your mask. So do that from the inside. Stick the plug through, align it, and then from the inside of the mask, press the silicone grommet into the metal grommet. Okay. So now it's pressed in, and I'm aligning the silicone ridges around the metal so that they're each side is hugging the metal grommet. Do the same thing to secure the alignment you'd like on the front side. Okay. Okay. So this is the completed Sip and Puff straw adapted mask from the front when the plug is open, then from the back. And when the plug is closed and the Sip and Puff straw is not being used, the mask will look like this. This time. So, okay.